Hi, I'm Greg, a sophomore at Princeton University, and today I'm going to teach you how I self-studied for the reading section of the SAT and improved my score by 140 points in just 3 months. In that short amount of time, I went from scoring in the low 600 range to nearly perfect, and by that I mean 750 to 800 every time. That might sound like an impossible improvement to you right now, but I guarantee you that literally anyone can do this. Well, maybe not anyone. I mean, if you don't have the motivation to sit down and watch this entire video to fully understand my SAT reading strategy, then you probably won't improve at all. But I have a little more faith in you guys than that. I guarantee you that if you listen to the information I'm about to provide you with and practice diligently, you will see results within a week. And I'm not exaggerating. Before we get into the strategy, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about my story. When I was in high school, believe it or not, I hated the critical reading section of the SAT. I remember taking multiple practice tests with absolutely no results. Most of the time, I could narrow it down to two or three answer choices, and somehow, I always ended up picking the wrong one. Other times, one of the choices I had ruled out was the correct answer, and I had spent all of my time trying to figure out which of two wrong answers was right. The College Board tricked me over and over again with these vague, similar-sounding, subjective answer choices. Even though I was taking lots and lots of practice tests, I wasn't seeing much improvement. It was then that I checked out a certain SAT strategy book at my local library. And my approach to the test completely changed. Completely. Within just 3 months of adapting this new SAT reading strategy, my score bumped up 140 points, an improvement that most people spend hundreds, if not thousands of dollars to get. 3 months may sound like a long time, but if you're trying to get into a highly selective college, it is absolutely worth your time. For me personally, getting a high score on the SAT early in my junior year allowed me to do more extracurricular activities, work on my college essays, keep my grades up, which eventually got me scholarships to lots of different schools, and also got me accepted to two Ivy League schools, University of Pennsylvania and Princeton. Speaking of getting into highly selective colleges, I just want to let you guys know that I am now offering private consulting sessions over Skype. Because I am a full-time student at Princeton, I can't accept that many students. So if you are interested, please sign up using the Google form below in the description. If you submit fast enough, I'll even give you a free 30-minute consultation. Can't wait to meet you. Now it's time to share with you the SAT reading strategy that got me the scores I wanted, which happened to be near perfect. The truth is, when you sit down to study for the SAT reading section, taking practice tests is not enough. Some people told me to just read more books or memorize long lists of vocabulary, but neither of these worked either. In fact, reading and analyzing more books as you would an English class will actually hurt your SAT reading score. Confused? Let me explain. Imagine you're in your high school English class and your teacher asks you to write an essay about a novel you all have been reading. What kind of essay are you writing in this scenario? Well, if you're an A student, you're probably analyzing some character, plot event, or the author's writing style based on your own original ideas. In your essay, you will definitely include quotes from the book that might imply your interpretation of the book. But the whole point of the essay is to say something more profound and impactful than what is already written in the text. In English class, the highest scorers have their own creative original ideas, and they argue for them well. However, the SAT reading section tests an entirely different skill. Because the test is multiple choice, there are a limited number of interpretations to choose from. The best you can do is look at the answer choices and choose the one that sounds the most similar, even if it doesn't exactly line up with your interpretation. However, the English class mindset is the mindset that most students have when taking the reading section of the SAT. If you want to improve your SAT reading score 100 plus points like I did, what you have to do is turn off your analytical mind. Here's why. The SAT is a standardized test. That means, by definition, that there must be an objective answer to each and every question. There is no interpretation involved at all. Each correct answer must be laid out explicitly in the text. There cannot be any debate over what the right answer is. Otherwise, the College Board would be sued many, many times over. So, the SAT reading section, in fact, is just as objective as the math section. Now, knowing this information and taking SAT practice tests will get you somewhere. But if the correct answer to every question is laid out explicitly in the text, the test writers have to include some very tricky answers that sound like they're directly in the text so that not everyone gets a perfect score. Don't worry though, identifying these tricks that the College Board uses is a learnable skill. The following books I'm about to recommend to you will help you identify what those tricks are, which types of questions are asked, and will help you to eventually earn that perfect score. For me, it only took less than 3 months, and for you, I'm sure you can get similar results. Before I get to these awesome SAT books though, please just give this video a like and subscribe to my channel. If you are a motivated middle or high school student looking to get into an elite university, you will love my videos on application essays, extracurricular activities, the common application, and everything else college admissions related. Now, back to my recommendations. The first book that I recommend is the SAT Black Book by Mike Barrett. In fact, this is the book that I checked out at my local library and ended up completely changing my philosophy on the SAT reading section. Actually, a lot of what I just told you earlier in the video came directly from Mike. If you're looking for a hands-on book that helps you to take advantage of the weaknesses inherent in a standardized test like the SAT, Mike Barrett's Black Book is my number one recommendation for you. In this book, he classifies several types of trick answers that the College Board throws into their questions, and helps you to recognize these patterns that show up time and time again on different practice tests as you're taking them. The book also includes detailed explanations of real SAT practice test questions, which you guys know that I love. This allows you to sort of put the theory that he teaches you into practice on real tests. Now, there are multiple editions of this book, so to make sure that you get the most up-to-date version, head down to the link in the description of this video, and it will send you directly to Amazon. Now, Mike Barrett's book alone will probably get you in the low 700 score, which for most of you watching is perfect, done. However, for those few students watching who are super motivated to get a perfect score on the reading section, I have another book recommendation for you. And that book is Erica Melchard's The Critical Reader. Frankly, this prep book contains more SAT reading knowledge than anyone should or could hope to know. In addition to time-saving and question-answering strategies, Melchard's book also contains a complete list of multi-meaning words that are included in the SAT reading section. What are multi-meaning words? Well, the words that have multiple meanings that the College Board often throws into their questions and answers to trick you. Although the book can get a bit dull and thick at times, it is the best I can do in terms of guaranteeing that you will score perfectly or near perfectly on the SAT reading section. Once again, I provided a link to this book as well in the video's description. It will send you directly to Amazon where you can buy it for a great price. Now, these tips and recommendations should result in a massive improvement in your SAT reading score. If you also happen to be studying for the SAT math section, you should head over to this video where I talk about my book recommendations for SAT math and also lay out a general study plan. But before you head over there, why don't you just give this video a real quick like and subscribe to my channel because, you know, it is free. See you next week.